Dear students, we just finished practice set 1.1, the question number 1, where the question was to show the rational numbers on a number line. We did two sums. I hope you solved the remaining sums and practiced it, because without that maybe you will not be able to understand this sum. So I presume that you have practiced it, and if you don't have your textbooks with you, please pause the video and pick up your textbook so you can follow me. So we go on to question number 2 of practice set 1.1, which says, observe the number line, this number line which I have drawn here for your ready reference, and answer the following questions. Answer the following. So these are the three questions which you have to do. But I would say, before you do these questions, it's better we use that technique which I told you, that the technique which I taught you to represent numbers on the rational line, and find out all these dots. What these dots represent rational numbers. So we'll see, we'll first find out what rational numbers do these dots represent. Okay, so very easy. As you can see, boys, between 0 and 1, if you see any two integers, if you see, there are four parts. Can you see this? One part, two parts, three parts, four parts. Here also, between 1 and 2, you can see there are three dots. In other words, there are four parts. This part, this part. If you can see, this part, this part, this part, and this part. So there are four parts. That means the first number, since there are four parts, the first number will be 1 upon 4. The second dot will be 2 upon 4. The third dot will be 3 upon 4. And the fourth dot will be 4 upon 4. Now we know we are right. Why? Because 4 upon 4 is 1. That means we are correct. That means the first number was 1 upon 4, 2 upon 4, 3 upon 4, 4 upon 4. That is, what is 4 divided by 4? 1. Then the next dot will be what after 4 upon 4 comes? 5 upon 4, 6 upon 4. Then we have 7 upon 4. Then we come, after 7 upon 4 comes 8 upon 4. What is 8 upon 4? 2. So that means we are correct. So we remove this. Then comes, after 8 upon 4 comes 9 upon 4. Then comes 10 upon 4. Then this dot is 11 upon 4. And finally, what is after 11 upon 4 comes 12 upon 4. What is 12 upon 4? 3. So 12 divided by 4 is 3. So I hope you understood this much. Now same way, we go to the left hand side. Just we started with 1 upon 4. Here we start with minus 1 upon 4. So minus 1 upon 4. Then we have minus 2 upon 4. Then we have minus 3 upon 4. Next we have minus 4 upon 4. What is minus 4 upon 4? Minus 1. Then we have minus 5 upon 4. Then we have minus 6 upon 4. Then we have minus 7 upon 4. Then we have minus 8 upon 4. What is 8 divided by 4? Minus 2. Same thing. That means we are correct. 9 upon 4. Minus 10 upon 4. Minus 11 upon 4. And then we have minus 12 upon 4. What is 4? 12 divided by 4? 12 minus 12 upon 4. That is minus 3. That means we were right. So let's, I'll rub these numbers below the main integers. That is 1, 2, and 3, and minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. Okay. Okay. So having said that, we now move on to, now once we found out all the numbers, then our sum becomes very easy to solve. Now what is the first question? Which number is indicated by point B? Now where is point B? Boys, here. Can you see? Which number is indicated? Can you see what is below B? Minus 10 upon 4. So what will be your answer? You will say minus 10 upon 4. Clear? Easy? So first thing what you do is, you have to first find out all these dots. What these dots represent? Which rational numbers? Okay, like this dot represents 3 upon 4. Something like that. So next question. Which point indicates the number 1, 3 upon 4? Now mind you, this is a mixed fraction. But what we have here are not mixed fractions. Okay, they are fractions, but not mixed fractions. Okay, they are either proper or improper fractions. So we are to first convert this into a fraction. So 4 ones are 4, 4 plus 3 is 7. So the answer is 7 upon 4. Is it clear how to, you all know how to convert mixed fraction into a proper fraction? So 4 ones are 4, 4 plus 3 is 7. So 7 upon 4. So which point indicates 1 3 upon 4 1 3 upon 4? That is which point? That what is 1 3 upon 4? It actually it is 7 upon 4. Where is 7 upon 4? If you see here, boys, 7 upon 4 is this point. Can you see 7 upon 4? C. So you will say point. The answer will be point C. So point C, as you see here, 7 upon 4. So point C represents 7 upon 4. Okay. Next, third one, true or false. We have to say whether it's true or false. The point D denotes the number 5 upon 2. 5 upon 2. So you see point D. Where is point D here? Just check it out here. Can you see? Does it denote 5 upon 2? Now you will say, array, but the here we can see 10 upon 4. It does not represent 10. It is here, it is showing 10 upon 4. But here they are asking whether D shows 5 upon 2. No, but there is a small catch in this. If you say 10 upon 4, can you see this 10 upon 4? D showing 10 upon 4. But if you simplify it, boys, so you get 2 2s are 2 5s are. So actually, you may say it is false. It is represented 10 upon 4. But no, you need to simplify it. What is 10 upon 4? If you 2 2s are 2 5s, if you simplify it, get 5 upon 2. That means our answer is true. You cannot say false. So please be careful. Sometimes if it's a improper fraction, you have to simplify it and make it, and simplify and scale it down, and then find out where. Then you decide whether it is true or false. Don't jump to conclusions. Okay. Thank you very much, boys. And I hope then now after next time we will begin with practice set 1.4. Now we learned how to represent rational numbers and number line. In practice set 1.4, we learn how to represent a irrational number on a number line. So we learn how to represent the irrational number. Yeah, thank you, boys.